Hey guys, what if here, and welcome back to NASCAR 2004, and it's not a points race, it's the All-Star race today. Last race was at Richmond. I actually did pretty freaking well. I got a top 10, and it was much better than I was honestly expecting. Showing you team management and what's going on in the garage. Chassis, we got one being overhauled for two more races. Engines, we got one being repaired for two more races, and bodies. We just got one more race for that being overhauled. So really nothing new being built or anything for now until the template's finished. And I'll probably work on that with a new body or whatever for that. So let's go into this race. We do have new chassis engines and all that going into this one. So it should be the best rating we ever had, considering all this is in the hundreds or 100%. And this is going to be our best chassis ever, which is something we've been desperately needing, because we've been in like the early 60s. So this is definitely the best body ever, so we'll see what this is going to be. Oh my god. We went from a 67 to a 70 here. Good god. Oh my gosh. Alright, so let's get into this All-Star race. Maybe we can win it. The All-Star race consists of three segments. Segment 1, you must take a 4-tire green flag pit stop and finish in the top 20 to advance. In segment 2, you must finish in the top 14. The field will then be inverted based on fan vote. The last segment is a 14-car race to the finish. Boy, that last segment's gonna be interesting to see how that kind of shakes up, if we can even get to that point, which I think we can do. We'll see what happens. We'll get this race going. I don't know why I'm making it really awkward. But anyways, let's get this race underway. It's an all-star race. Virtual dough. We'll see what happens. 3, 2, 1. Green flags out. We're underway here in the all-star race. 10 laps in the first segment. Jeff Burton is right behind us, and I'm sure he's very, very salty. Can't remember what I did to him. It's been a few days since I last recorded a race here on this game, but to you guys, you really won't notice a difference because I've been uploading them every day, but I can't remember what it was, so, oh god. But yeah, it's we'll see what happens here with Jeff Byrne. It looks like it's not going to be an issue because we just kind of drove right by him, but we actually didn't have that bad of a restart. That was actually like probably one of the better ones of this track, because normally it takes like a whole lap just for the car to kind of get up to speed. And here, I can already tell there's a massive improvement just in terms of just overall speed in the body that it has. So, very good. Once the templates are in, I'm really curious to see how the car will be when that's put in. Because everything else, for the most part, is pretty good. But the body was just the one thing I needed a lot of work on. And it went from being the worst part of the car to now the best part of the car. So, very interesting how that kind of happened. But we're in P12 now. We're actually kind of keeping up with these guys up ahead of me in here, so that's very good. And Harvick's blown up, and oh god, that was so close. I almost ran into him. Oh my gosh, that I almost died a little bit there. But yeah, this car's pace, we're just keeping up with these guys for now. We don't have track position, which is kind of hurting us a bit. I'm trying to play it very carefully, because again, I don't have to, you know, go all out here. I just need to finish in the top 20, which is what I'm doing. I need to keep, because remember, when each round's advance, the cars can body or whatever stays the same. So if you have damage on it, it will carry over to the next round. So try to be careful with that. Don't want to get any unnecessary damage. So for now, we're just chilling. We're in eighth. We have a good car. I can feel it. I'm just trying not to overdo it right now. And as soon as I say that, I go off the track to pass somebody for a position. So good job, what if, for being an idiot. That's nothing new, though. I always do stupid shit. And I think Jeff Gordon's the leader with, I can't even tell who's in second. I think Jeff Gordon's leading it. It's hard to tell. We're about to pass, oh my god, I forgot. Sterling Marlin. Why was that so hard to think about? We get by him for sixth. Try to get by Bobby Labonte. I will be pitting on lap 7 going into 8, so that's my strategy. I mean, it's not anything too crazy, so I don't think it's a shock, but okay, it is Dale Jarrett in second. So I got a little bit closer to him, I've been able to see. But yeah, I'm super, super happy with this car. Just finally things are turning around this season. I don't know how other races will be, because I was thinking, you know, because it's weird, because one race, like after Richmond, I'm just thinking to myself, yeah, I can win this championship. I can maybe pull a miracle out. Then another race will be horrible, and then I'll be like, yeah, there's no way I'm going to win it. So a lot of mixed emotions I keep getting throughout this career mode. But as of right now, this car is really good because, you know, with the bodies and conditions and everything, it won't carry over to the next race. Like, the conditions or anything won't get any worse. So this will be the car we'll be using for the All-Star race, and if that's the case, which, I mean, it will be the case, it's going to be a good car. Could win the damn freaking race, so which will be good because that race pays out pretty freaking well. Pitting this time, 70 miles an hour. We get down pit road, all four tires. Let's just see what our pit crew can do here. There's a 15.8. I saw the estimated time was a 16.05, I believe. So a little bit better than the estimated time. We lost a little bit of ground, but nothing too bad. We're going to get ahead of Jimmy Johnson. We might end up being maybe inside like the top 10, I think, give or take. I don't know, but we'll see. It was very interesting first half. A lot of action, per se. I mean, actually having pace is a nice thing at Charlotte. Charlotte is one of the few tracks on this game, as well as Texas, where it feels like the AIs are a little bit too easy. So I think even in Season 1 stuff, I was even having much better runs than I normally would. But as for now, we're in a pretty good shape for this All-Star race, and really just playing our cards right, trying not to do something stupid like hitting the wall or anything. We get up to P5, and it looks like from here on out, I obviously we'll advance to the next round. I mean, it's not really anything to be surprised with. But yeah, just one more lap to go, and segment will be over. Off of turn 4, gonna get 5th place in the first segment. Pretty good. Honestly, way better than Season 1 where I barely squeaked in, because every round I just barely made it. Gordon wins the first segment, Junior 2nd. Terrell Bonnie 8th, by the way, I just noticed that, so pretty good for him. Harvick's obviously gonna get eliminated, and he's the only guy out because he blew an engine. So this will be the next segment where I should be in the top 5, I think? Yeah, top 5, alright. And the green flag's out. Segment 2 begins. We'll just have to finish 14th or better in this segment and see what happens in the way the field inverts, because it's just random, so I could either be first or in the back, I don't know. But we can have decent starts. Like, that was not super bad. I mean, we only like lost like 2 spots, so that's like amazing. Terry Labonte doesn't give me any room, so thank you, Terry, for being rude like that. It kind of hurt my feelings. And we clear him, we're in P6. If we just keep up with these guys in the draft and everything, I'd like to say we can win, but it's a good show. Oh my god, Kurt Busch. It's a good possibility. And we're keeping up with them right now. Almost gonna clear Kurt for 5th. Jeez, I forgot how much harder this game is compared to NASCAR Heat. The AI drivers definitely are a lot, this game is so much better than that. I don't even want to compare it. It's like an insult. But we have a couple more laps left to go, about 5 to go. Might get to Gordon. I think I might be able to get to Gordon. I keep saying that. I feel like I'm going to jinx myself, but I don't know. Maybe if we win the race, the fans will be like, oh my gosh, this Davey Quickie guy is amazing. Maybe we should like make him be the winner or something by picking him first in the invert thing. I don't know. I'm just thinking about the All-Star. I'm not thinking about the All-Star. I mean, I am thinking about the All-Star. So I'm thinking about Charlotte and the Coke 600 and everything. It's like, if we have decent pace here, then we have a good shot to win it, because it's a long race, and it seems like we have still a pretty good long-running car. A win could be quite possible there, which would be nice, because that gives us so much extra money. Nipped the side of Junior there a little bit, got some damage. That little nick isn't going to do anything to our car, so I'm not going to be too worried about that. You know, a couple laps left to go. I think maybe we can catch Gordon. We are in his draft a little bit, so I think maybe we can get him. Just gonna have to hit our marks here and be very careful, and maybe winning this segment could be within our grasp. I don't know. It'd be nice. It would be very nice to win this segment, though. Actually, I don't remember if you finish second, you don't get anything unless you win. Does the payout be like if you win, you? I don't know. I forget, because I never won the All-Star race in Kerma, so I don't know how that works. But I'll find out if I do win, which we'll see. But right up there with Jeff Gordon, the car kind of slid up the track just a little bit, and the tires are starting to get worn, so that's not good. We got two laps up to go now. We hit the line, and we're going to try to get into the inside of Gordon going into one, and braked a little bit early, and we hold the bottom pretty well, and we clear him. It's nice to have a good pace car. We clear Gordon, now it's just time to pull away and just win the second segment. Off of turn four into the tri-oval, we will win the second segment. Pulled away from Gordon pretty quick, honestly, so that gives me very good hope. I just hope we can win this All-Star race. That'd be nice to get like an extra million, because we're in a little bit of deficit. And Donkey Mark's first. Terrell Bonnie, who started 8th, I think, in the second segment, so I'm surprised how much he lost ground. I don't know where I am. Oh my god. Okay, so we're 9th. We're side by side with Gordon. We're probably gonna have a horrible start, so I'm gonna hope that we can get to the inside. Oh my god. Okay, that was a dirty way to do it, but we did it. Now I have to worry about Jeff Burton, which actually he's too far back. He shouldn't be an issue, but we got 5 to go. We already got to the inside line, the lane I really wanted to be in. So now it's just all a matter of how much ground can we gain. Can we go from 9th to 1st in like 5 laps? I don't know. A couple of those cars up there I don't think are the fastest in this race. I think me, Gordon, and Junior were the top 3. So maybe they will hold up everybody and just get by them pretty quickly. Couple laps. Again, this is only a 5 lap shootout, so it's going to be very, very quick. These laps are going to tick by, and we're already almost about to clear Sterling Marlin for 8th. Trying to get to Jimmy, but he's freaking blocking the whole track for 7th. I think Mark Martin's still leading. Yeah, he still is leading. Maybe we can get to Jimmy off of 4. Not quite. I don't know if the tire... Okay, the tire wear is reset. It's back to normal, so I guess we had a pit off camera, I'm assuming. But I don't know. It's going to be close. Oh, come on! I just don't think it'll be enough. I'm not getting through this field as quick as I wanted. It's going to be a last lap. It might be a last lap finish. It might be a photo finish if I'm lucky. Just going to try to go into 3 here and try to get a good run off. I really need to start gaining some ground like right now. So, Jarrett, I need to get by you. He's pinching me down there. He's doing what he needs to do to defend his position, but I need to go. I'm 7/10 back. I know I have a car to win. I just need to get through this field. We're right there. It's not going to be enough. See, but I need to get to Junior now. I don't care how much he's going to block. I have to go all the way down here. I'm going to really have to put faith in the Carter going into 3. Oh, God. Okay. Well, that didn't work out. I think that's all she wrote. I don't think I can get there in time. Sucks. Get to Junior's inside here. White flags out. One more time around the racetrack. About to clear Junior. Might get to Stewart going into 1. Slide up the track just a little bit. If we can get to Kenseth, I'm going to be a lap short. I'm just going to be a little bit short catching Mark, but Kenseth actually doesn't even give me a fight. He just lets me go, so no team wars there. Final corner in the last lap. Can we get to Mark Martin? It's all or nothing here. I need a gain. Oh my god, it's not going to be enough. I'm going to be so freaking close. Mark wins the All-Star race. I get second. Fuck. Oh my god. Oh, if only the invert thing, I was like a road ahead. It was not like an 8th or whatever, 10th. I think I was 10th. I'm not even going to get any money for that either. 50K. Oh my god. I can repair one thing in the engine shop or body shop, whatever. That broke my heart a little bit. I don't know what I could have done there. I got through the field as best I could. I made some moves. I did everything. God. Fucking invert thing. God, that pisses me off a little bit. Well, I mean, the Coke 600's next. I just really wanted extra million. I don't think the shop editions. No, it doesn't carry over. So, yeah, that's it. Mark wins the All-Star race. Good job, Mark. I just need another lap or be another row ahead. Well, that's it. Next race will be the Coke 600. I'm very confident that I can maybe win that one, even though I said maybe. I think it is possible considering the pace we had. Once we get up to the front, just haul ass, I think we can definitely win it. So we'll see. But that's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Like I always say, I do appreciate the love, feedback, and support all you guys give me in the comment section below, and as well as liking the video, because it helps me out a lot in the long run. I'll see you all in the Coca-Cola 600. And as always, have a good day, everyone.